cell phones, maybe, you know, and phones. Text messages, you know. But she is always there to help us, you know. She is, all we know now, you know, she is a expert physical doctor and spiritual doctor, and, you know, we can benefit from whatever way we can, you know. She has a lot of blessings from Papaji, you know. So, with that, anybody who still wanted to say on the birthday related topics, we can have still that thing going first.
Seva and Mahatmyaktas. What inspire? Unless and until it's Agnya, it is never done with Mahatmya. But what inspires inside to do the Mahatmyaktas Seva? We do Seva, whatever is devoted to us. But what is the reason that gives our mind, what inspires us?
It's a very good question. And I'm sure she knows the answer, but this is for us, you know. For benefit of all of us, you know, that we do seva or service. But how do we get with the magnanimity? How do we get with the positive feeling? How do we get without getting bored or without getting lazy or tired, you know? How do we have that kind of seva or service with the magnanimity, you know? And in Yogi Gita, Yogi Bapa has answered that, you know. And Yogi Bapa is referring from the Vachanamrut. Lord Swami Narayan and Gunatitanand Swami has said that, you know, that in order to create the magnanimity, we need ammunition. We need a boost. And that boost can come varieties of ways, you know. There are ways that somebody who would do an austerity or penance out of frustration, you know, and would be very strong, you know, and very powerful, you know, in doing that, you know, or out of unhappiness, you know. There is a story about in Srimad Bhagavatam, you know, Chitraketu king, you know, the king Chitraketu, that he was a king and he wanted to have a prince. In order to have the prince, he married many, many women. But the problem was with him, so he could not have children or child. And in our scripture, it is said that he had how many wives? Harsha Ben? 10 million wives. तमें एक टको बोले 100 करोड़. But it is just to set in mind, in our mind, an example, you know, that he was so interested in having a child, you know, to carry on his kingdom, you know. And it was not materializing. So finally, a sage came to his kingdom. And he served the sage very sincerely and very zealfully, you know. and with the magnanimity, you know. And then saint says, okay, I'm living, but is there something, I fulfill your wish, you know. And he was ready. He says that, yes, all I did is for this purpose. That I would like to have a prince. So the sage saw that and he knew that, you know, it's not in his seven births, you know, seven births, you know, in his seven lives, you know. But since he did this seva with magnanimity, he gave a fruit and says, give it to your dear queen and she would have a baby, you know. And then that fruit was given and a baby was born, you know. Baby was very healthy, but because the baby was born to a mother, that queen became the main queen, you know, very adorable queen, you know, to the king, you know. So all the other queens, they were parallel to that queen or even higher than that queen, became jealous, saying that our focus and interest is gone now. The king is going to be now more focused with the prince and the queen, you know. So they had a bad gathering, you know. And they say, what should we do? How can we change this thing, you know? And they came up with the bad idea, you know. Say, why don't we kill the prince? Even, you know, few days old baby, you know. And they poisoned the baby and baby died, you know. All this effort went down to the drain. And sage had blessed him. So now it is working for his betterness and he became renounced from the world, you know. He became so renounced that he quit the kingdom and everything. He went to the mountains and did the austerity and penance, you know. There is a long story after that, but point is that that kind of strong feeling to do go for penance and, you know, meditation comes from this purpose, you know. The point was, you know, that even after gaining that, he could not get rid of his ego. And he was laughing at his God, you know, and goddess, Lord Shiva and Parvati. And Parvati cursed him to become a demon. So at the end, you know, he ended up like a demon, you know. So there is a process when somebody can have a zealful or with magnanimity, but if it is done by some raw ingredients, then it will have the poor result, you know. But what Swaminarayan Bhagavan has said in Vachanamrita and Gunatitanand Swami and Yogi Bapa has referred is to have the association of a Gunatit saint. Sukh Sankadik Jeva, the saints like Sukhdev Ji or Sankadik, at that time Swaminarayan Bhagavan referred to that, you know. Jeva koi mota satpurush no prasang hoy, to mahatma yukta bhakti uday thai. Then it starts lightening up. Not at the full fledged, you know. It just starts beginning to light up, you know. Uday thai, it just starts rising, you know. It's the seeds that is putting in, grows to a bigger tree later, you know. So the short answer is that we should have to have a company of Gunatit saint to have that kind of devotion. The second thing is that to gain the blessings, to receive the blessings of such Gunatit saint, again it comes from our efforts, purush prayatna, that we have to make an effort to do that. And in our effort, If we make mistakes, you know, then also we are not getting 100%, you know. We are getting less than 100%. So it is combination of both, you know. Our own effort and the blessings of Gunatit saints generates that kind of Mahatma Yukta Seva. Maybe I gave you a little quick and short, you know. And the reason is that I want to hear more people. Then it Uday thai. And Uday thai pashi madhyane aave, you know.
Hard work to please, so they learn from each other. There's a whole unit who is like Tardev. They have a whole unit. So they all do Mahatmya Yukta Seva, like Jyotiben, Sonaba, Sena. Whosoever comes newer, they all have this same feeling. Jyotiben is doing so much thing, let me help her. Then Jyotiben teaches. Next day, next month, next year, next time, they also learn. And by that way, also this happens. What I saw here, that's why I'm just asking, okay, what inspires all these people to do the Mahatmya Yukta Seva?
You and you doing Seva, Papaji and Kakaji, and with that focus, I
make sure, okay, to start with, it's just the love and affections. And after doing seva and to be with him, gradually and with katha varta, with blessings, with so much different discourses, it creates the glory of Papaji, whom I am serving. He looks like human being, he just talks like human being, but so someday 50%, someday 70% believe he is like a Gunatit Swarup. But now to go back, I feel it's never been a 100% what I served him. It's not a 100%, it's a Supreme Divine Guru, Supreme Divine Guru Hari. And that's why I'm just thinking all these boys are so much hardworking to please you. So get pleased upon them. Jai Swaminarayan.
And when she says that she did it for 50%, 70%, that is in her way of giving the grades, you know. Papaji would always give 15% when you have done 100% what we are doing now here, you know. So she has received more than 15% from Papaji, so you know, we cannot compare that, okay, you know, we are doing much higher than her, you know. It's a known fact. I'm going with references, you know, I don't make up my stories. So now, somebody wants to say something about Nilamben on her birthday. Oh, you want to say? Huh?
Yeah. Sajanand Swami Maharaj Nije. Today, our Swati Ben has come for the first time in Beno Sabha. In Beno Sabha? नहीं बेनो सभा में नहीं आई पण એટલે सी हैज कम टू सत्संग सो वी हैड गॉन टू सी शेफाली एंड वी वर गोइंग टू हैव डिनर देयर सो सिंस आई आस्क्ड हर सी वर्क्स विद पंकज अंकल सो आई आस्क्ड हर इफ यू आर फ्री शी लाइक्स टू कम टू सी वांटेड टू कम एंड सी शेफाली सो आई आस्क्ड हर इफ सी वाज फ्री टुडे मे बी वी कैन हैव डिनर टुगेदर एंड सी कैन मीट श्रुति एंड विकास एंड देन वी कैन कम हियर फॉर सभा एंड she was, everything worked out and she came. So while coming in the way, we were talking about the main thing about not judging people, that the greatest sin is to judge people and make our own judgment on other people's work. So I was telling her that when we judge other people, we take doubt in Bhagwan's kartartapanu, ke Bhagwan jo chalavta hoy, chata bhi apne koi nama judgment kariye. So she was saying that, but what if somebody has really been unfair to us? And it is very hard to accept because of her own life. Her husband had not treated her well, and now she has a daughter. And her daughter is without the father, and because of that, mother and daughter both have to suffer. So she was saying, how can I not feel that it was bad? And how can I see any good in that? So I said, we'll talk about that. Sajanand Sai Maharaj Ji. I did say that, of course, there is always a plan. It is very hard to understand that why something happens in our life. And I was just, we already had received, almost reached our home. So I said that, you know, so many people died in World Trade Center. What was their fault? Or how do we know what happened? So we cannot answer all the questions. But when this thing happened in your life, you had two choices. Either to curse him and be unhappy about it and every day curse him 100 times and be unhappy again and again and again, or close that chapter. Okay, worst thing happened, but close that chapter. At this stage, what do you want to do now? And so that's where we were. So I said, what can you do yourself to better your life? Sajanand Sai.
Why not giving the other way, that praise him a lot, thank him a lot, that whatever the good times and good days you had with him and whatever good memory you had with him, that was part of your chart, and when it finished, you had something better to do with you, with your daughter, and now you are into this kind of company and group, that you would really benefit a lot without any restriction, you know. If you want to come here, would your husband stop you now? So, you know, take it as a positive, right? But if that scenario or that situation has given you a turning point in your life, then think positive, right? I just gave that as an example, you know, right? That Chitraketu Raja, you know, he had a turning point, right? But you don't want to keep thinking negative, you know. When you think negative, it becomes negative in your mind, you know. You cannot get out of that negativity, you know. You cannot get out of the unhappiness, you know, because of that negativity. So the choice is yours, you know. That, yeah, you can be a judge and say, this was wrong, that was wrong, that was wrong, you know. But at the end of the day, what have you gained, you know? You have gained only the negativity. Instead, if you think, whatever God has done, let me see in a positive way, you know, and let me think positive. Let me pray for him. Let me pray for whatever is he has given me, you know, whatever he has done, you know, good to me, you know. If you think positive and good, you know, then you would be happy. And we have a two-way radio station, so no. This one and his. And there is always communication on subconscious level, you know. We don't know. But a negative thought would send what kind of signal there? Negative or positive? Negative, right? And if you think positive, then it will send positive signals. The next question is, what is your intention? Do you want to have him come back and make you happier than before again? Huh? And I don't want to change your heart, you know. But I can just give you the ideas, you know, and you decide to change or not, you know. But your heart is doing this or saying this because you have gathered the series of negative memories, you know, with him. If you put that aside and keep the positive memories with him, your heart will change, you know. Then, if your heart changes, then your mind will change. Your mind change, the vibration will change. Vibration will change, he will change. He change, his mind will change. His heart will change. And the whole cycle will be done. We come in our each other's life, not just by like this. There is a series of, you know, occurrence in the past our lives, you know, and that brings us together and we create some new good or not so good, and that again prepares another jungle of difficulties, you know. So it is our choice, you know. But since, you know, Harsha Ben is your lawyer, you know, so we are just trying to give you the ideas, you know, that how you can be happy, you know, that's all. And since you have come, we will all pray for you, you know, and that prayer always works, you know. So why don't we do 2 minutes dhun for her, you know, and we pray that whatever is best in your chart, let that happen. Unless this is an open prayer, you know. Whatever is best in your chart, let it happen. You want to have a close prayer? Then you say, and we will pray for that, you know. That he should be miserable, or he should be all this, or all that. We will not do that, you know. I'm just telling you. But there is a prayer, an open prayer and close prayer. Close prayer is that you have one definite thought in mind. This is what I want, God, and I want it. I want a lottery win, you know, or this and that, you know, and then you pray. Not guaranteed that it would make you winner of lottery, you know, but it is a close prayer, that is for sure. And then open prayer is, you know, if it is okay for you, then let it happen. If it is best for you, let it happen. So choice is yours, but we will pray for 2 minutes and we are all with you, okay? And we will pray in Mahapuja also. Our Amit Bhai performs Mahapuja every Sunday. So in that we will pray also, you know. All we want to do is see you smiling and happy, and you be a good guide for your daughter, you know. Yeah. Good idea? Okay, let's do prayer for 2 minutes, huh? Sajanand Swami Maharaj in Jai. Samnarayan, 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 Om Narayan, 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 हरकचंद भाई, कांति भाई, शांति भाई, सुरेश भाई, योगिनी बहन, प्रतिमा बहन, शारदा बहन, जयू बहन, लीलू बहन, मालती बहन, भारती बहन, बा बहन, तारा बहन, ज्योति बहन, प्रेम बहन, बेला बहन, आनंदी बहन, दास स्वामी, प्रेम स्वामी, कोठारी स्वामी, मुकुंजीवन स्वामी, शास्त्री स्वामी, निर्मल स्वामी, शांति भाई, स्वामी भाई, घनश्याम भाई, कांति काका, प्रणवी लाड, मुल्कानी सेठ, किशोर भी, मास्टर हंसा दीदी, हिमत स्वामी, अरबी साई, गुणादी स्वरूप, हे महाराज, हमारा गुना माफ कर जो, सर्वना देश काड सुधार जो, सर्वने सुखिया सुखिया कर जो, बड़ बुद्धि ने प्रणाम जो, हे महाराज हमारी भूल चूक थई हो तो माफ कर जो, आपना गमता मा सहजे सहजे वर्ताव जो, सजानंद स्वामी महाराज नी जय जय जय, आज के आनंद की जय जय जय। धुन करता करता मने एक बीजी भी इच्छा थी, नीलम बेन हेज कम इन टच विथ सो मेनी डिवोटीज एंड यू नो पीपल लाइक अस यू नो, एंड शी मे हैव सम यू नो एडवाइस ऑल्सो, सो आप भी थोड़ी कहीं कमने सूचन सलाह आपो।
सहजानंद स्वामी महाराज ने जे, आई डोंट नो एक्जेक्टली व्हाट्स द सिचुएशन, बट आई जस्ट अंडरस्टैंड द मैरिज लाइफ प्रॉब्लम दिस एंड दैट, ऑलरेडी डिवोर्स, whatever has done been done, you cannot change, you cannot go back, so now what is in front of you is to be think of, and what you can do you find out by yourself what you can do. First thing, stay with the daughter or getting other marriage. Second thing, just find out what are the positive powers in you, what sort of life you can live, like you know more your mind and you know more your strength, but where living independently and going ahead with the life is not that bad or is not that difficult. At the same time, when you feel alone, there is a big deal of satsang here. At the same time, God helps you. Make a habit whosoever God you believe, make a habit, ask for the strength, ask for the support, and ask for the help. After all, how much you can do, if there is a limit to your capacity. Add to your capacity God's power, power of prayer, and your will. Your willpower is to be increased by your prayers. And that prayer, how to do that prayer, that will be teaching here. So make an effort to come here to learn more how to pray, how to meditate, how to find out your positives in you. Because I don't know how much I have capability. But because I came in the satsang, I was doing some seva, God make me to learn myself. And there are so many incidents that I can progress without my effort and without my knowing, by only His grace. So when you need a grace to go ahead, you have to be in the lotus feet of any saint, any temple, any god. And that will give you energy. And that energy will take you to some positive stride. Give some time. Have some space of time without your thinking so much in this way or that way. Keep quiet. Watch your mind, watch your thought. And just wait for a couple of months and learn from your mistakes. Learn from what you did before and learn from your thoughts. This negative thought has also maybe spoiled your daughter's thinking also. Something around you also, your house also. So always have positive stride in you also. So search for that, and that searching will come from prayer and to be alone in yourself with quietness, calmness, and tranquility. Jai Swaminarayan.
So let's go back to Nilambe's birthday. No, no. Ajo to sadano tha. Aajni sabha khas aapni vidai ane aap amara thi dur na jao. And aapni birthday. Rachna wants to say, doctor to doctor talk.
Sajanan Swami Maharaj Nijay, happy birthday Nilamben. I think this was the first opportunity I really had to spend time with Nilamben. I'd always seen her like in different functions and things, and I always knew she was a doctor and that everyone would always tell me she's very cool and all this kind of stuff. But this time when we had the ladies' shibir, I unfortunately couldn't attend a lot of the actual shibirs because I was working. But later I was sitting with Nilamben having lunch, and I asked her if she had asked everybody to tell kind of their story of how they got into satsang and all this. And so I was like, Nilamben, did you tell your story? Did I miss it? And she was like, yes, I did, but I'll tell you again. And so then we both just sat next to the pool, and eventually there was a whole crowd that kind of gathered around us. And she started telling me about her story, which Falguni went through a lot during Friday Sabha. But the things that were going through my head as she was telling me this, you know, not only did she always have that desire to do something more, something great. But she also is a brilliant physician, very, very accomplished. And, you know, I'm not at all a brilliant physician or anything. I'm just very blessed and lucky. But I saw that she is so intelligent, and I've met other physicians that are also intelligent, and they have a lot of spunk and energy and drive. And she used this towards medicine, but it seems that that same energy and spunk and drive, she used it also for something that's more meaningful and more beyond just a career and medicine and other things, and that was for her liberation and for the seva of Papaji. And I just found that so inspiring and so unique that... And it also made me think, when she was telling me about how she actually started to stay in the mandir and other things, that how destined she also is and what a blessed soul that she is. And I feel so very lucky that you spent this much time with us and that we got to have your blessings and your teachings on how to do things. Another thing that I found very unique is she's, and I think Harshanti had mentioned this on Friday, is that she's just very, very humble and very much just blending in with everybody. We all know that she's very special, very divine, very elevated, but when everybody's in the pool and it's only 75 degrees or 80 degrees outside and the pool is cold, she went in too, and it seemed that she enjoyed, and everybody enjoyed so much because she joined in and made the normal kind of pool time and swimming a more divine activity. You know, we have the habit of sometimes just sitting around and talking, gossiping, talking about movies or things like that. But with Neelam Ben there, the conversation was more directed. It came to an elevated level that was so much fun too. Her presence just made the shibir amazing, and her attitude, her humbleness was just something I very, very much admire. Even at the end when we had the whole issue with the septic tank, I was like, you know, I'm so sorry, Neelam Ben. It's like so hodgepodge here. And then she's like, hodgepodge means khichdi. And I like khichdi. And so I was like, even with that, I mean, it's kind of go with the flow. And so thank you so much. I hope that every year you make this trip, because it really meant a lot to all of us women for you to be at the shibir, for you to spend so much time with all of us.